fact, I was supporting a terrorist band, a terrorist group, and you said there are videos. That's not true. That's not true. It's not true, and as you know, every declaration, every opinion I have is very well known, because the right press in my country have used everything. But you said here, you said "Gora eta," and this is terrible, because I have to say, with all my respect, you are a liar. I didn't interrupt you, even if you were lying. My opinion regarding terrorist groups is that we have the law, and we have a state of right, and we have a penal code in order to combat that, and there is no doubt about it. And Podemos condemn, Podemos is against any form of terrorism. My opinion regarding Venezuela, I could say it's a beautiful country, but I think you are asking me my opinion about the government of Venezuela. My opinion is that there are some things that the government in Venezuela, the present government, did well, and others they didn't do the things well. And regarding the last question, I don't remember. What was the last question? The salary. This is strange, because we are the only members of the European Parliament that gave through two or three parts of our salary. It's for a member of the Parliament, if you are a member of Podemos, you can take more than three minimum salaries. That is less than 2,000 euros per month, and I think it's a good salary. But in that case, I think we are an example in our country. The salary of a member of the European Parliament is more than 6,000 euros per month, and we just take less than 2,000. When I was professor in the university, my salary was 950 euros per month, and I was happy with that, because I don't have children and I don't have health problems, but I think answer your questions. The reason why should you vote for me for a president, I don't know. The best thing of democracy is that you can choose, and you have many options. Probably you will never have the chance to ask questions to the other candidates. you can do your choice. Thank you.
Majority, what would Podemos do during the first month to deal with the Troika?
We will try to implement a social rescue plan, a citizen rescue plan. And the first thing we really want to do is to end evictions. The evictions in my country, the war in Spanish is desahucios. I don't know if the translation is correct.
Yeah, correct.
When I say evictions. And the evictions probably in our country were the best expression of the injustice situation we live, where the banks that had a big responsibility in the crisis were protected by the government and were allowed to put the people out of the houses. And it was a terrible image to see the police taking the people from the houses. I would like to be a president in a country where the police is going to take the people with responsibilities in the crisis, and that's the reason we understand that to finish the evictions will be a great first decision of our government.
We're going to take one more question from each side.
Hola, Pablo. A difficult question. Do you think Syriza's ability to execute their program successfully, and if they fail, not because they are not right, but because the enemies are more powerful, they might win, do you think that will condition Podemos' ability to win electorally in the popular perception of Spain?
Now all the people is favoring Syriza and Podemos, and we have a great relationship. We are friends, and we are very happy with the success of Syriza in Greece. I think it's the best news for Greece people. Finally, they have a Greece president, not a delegate of Angela Merkel. Rule a country is very difficult, and if the economy of your country is destroyed and you are in the European Union and you have many of the financial powers against you, the margin you have to rule a country is quite small. But I think the Greek comrades are very clever, and they understand how this chess game works. And I think they are going to do the things very well. But we were not the cause of we couldn't help Syriza to win the elections in Greece. Greek people had to do their own homework, and for us it will be the same in Spain. I really want that the Greek government succeed in his work, and I'm sure they will do it because they have really good ideas. But our history is going to be completely different, and obviously we can learn many things in Greece, but we have many things to learn also here in the state and in other countries, and nobody is going to give us the victory of the elections. Just if the citizens in Spain understand that we can be a tool in their hands in order to change their lives, the victory of Podemos will be possible in Spain.
We're going to share a question since there's only one allowed. And we'll make it short. So we know that even the reforms that we're going to win when we win the election are not going to be able to be done just by government alone, right? It's going to require mass mobilizations of the population, of the working class of people. But you didn't address any of that in your talk, so I wonder if you can address some of that now and the importance of non-electoral activity in order to affect change in the electoral arena.
And very, very fast and listo. If I was Spanish, Pablo, I would vote you. You are great. I'm Catalan. I have a nation. I also... No, bueno. A ver, escúchame un momento. Encantada de hablar contigo también. So, you support... We are the same, actually, because you have a dream. I have a dream. You support the Palestinian state. I support the Palestinian state and the Israeli, too. In my case, both. Yes, so Catalana, if you support the referendum for the Catalan society, will you actively campaign towards the no? Because you say you talk about patria And my country is the Catalan one, and I love Spain, as I love any country in the world. Pero mi patria es la catalana. Gracias y adelante, que lo está haciendo muy bien.
I got the second question. As you know, in Podemos, we defend the right of Catalan people to decide. And to decide about everything, not just about the national issue of independence. We think that the only possible way to discuss about this possibility is to open a constituent process in all the states. And I'm very clear with this. I support a referendum in Catalonia, in Països Catalans. We have to define the area. But I think that in order to make any decision about the territorial situation in the Spanish state, we need to open a constituent process and to discuss about the right to decide about this issue and more issues. Regarding my opinion, in Podemos there are people that in that referendum will vote yes, will vote no, and will vote yes, no. So, because it's possible to have different opinions in Spain. In Podemos. If you ask me, I respect that many citizens in Catalonia, they feel themselves not Spaniards, but Catalans. I respect that. But it's true that there are many citizens too that feel themselves Spaniards and Catalans, or Catalans and Spaniards. And my opinion is, I don't want that Catalonia could go away. But I think that the decision is a decision that should be made for the Catalan citizens in a constituent process. I think I've been very clear with this.
Bueno, pero, so you're saying that the Spanish together they have to decide, not only the Catalans.
The problem is the possibility. Me and you, we can define the situation. And the only possibility to create different relations between the different nations in Spain, I think that Spain is a plurinational reality. I think that there are different nations in Spain, is to open a constituent process. And I don't believe, for instance, when Artur Mas said this is a problem between us and the Spanish government, I don't believe them, because I know very well what Artur Mas represents. When the problem is the money, they have just one nation, the money. And some of the elites of the Catalonia leadership are exactly the same that the members of the Partido Popular.
That's it. But you talk about Syriza, you, the coup. We have the coup, okay. So you can be.
Senor, we have coup. Vale.
Sorry and thank you. Gracias.
And I respect so much coup, and I have a great admiration for David Fernandez and Kimaru Fata and other colleagues, even if we don't have the same opinion regarding all the issues. The first question, of course, we will need a popular movement in order to change the things in our country. That's the reason, of course, we organized the demonstration of the change, the Marcha del Cambio, last month with more than 200,000 people in Puerta del Sol. It was something amazing. We know very well that we are not able to change the country. We need civil society, we need social movements, we need to empower the people in order to change the things. It's not possible to make change just with a government. You need to organize civil society, organized popular movement in order to create new possibilities for real democracy in our country.
So, big round of applause for Pablo Iglesias.
Thank you.
start by saying thank you. I speak on behalf of New York when I say we appreciate your